What's wrong now, bud?
There's too much panic in this town. I'm going deeper underground. When I was a young kid, around 11, I want to say, one of my favorite web shows on YouTube was a little channel by the name of SML, aka Super Mario Logan. The channel really appealed to me since they were using puppets instead of actual actors, and making everything so wacky, goofy, and quote-unquote funny for kids such as myself. Another reason why I absolutely love the show is because of this absolute fucking deal lid by the name of Jeffy. Originally a one-time character, Jeffy would go on to become an absolute icon of the series, and then turn this show from something that was alright for kids and teens to an absolute toddler's paradise that makes absolutely tons and tons of money. And then the episode Jeffy's Parents, it's revealed that Jeffy is actually a son of a painter that was very, very rich. And then also in the episode, it's revealed that once he becomes 18, he gets all the money. And so, because of that, I've been waiting for that event for quite a long time as a kid. And then puberty happened. And since I got old, I also got old of SML and stopped caring about it. And then I would later on to go and watch actual good web shows. Like I'm So Runner. And because of that, I missed out on such good classics such as, Jeffy the Donut King. Or, Jeffy's allergies? Yeah, fuck it, I did the right decision. However, Kieran's 11-year-old spirit was still inside my body and was just telling me, go for it. Watch this special, Kieran.
The fuck are you talking about?
Oh. Fuck. That's right, ladies and gents, the long-awaited The long-awaited Super Mario Logan movie is finally out, titled Jeffy's 18th Birthday. And boy, let me tell you, SML fans all over the world were out crying for this. What will happen to Jeffy? Will he fucking die? And that hot topic was taking over social media by storm. Is what I would be saying if everyone took 5 shits for SML. And for nostalgic reasons, I decided, sure, why not? I'll watch this piece of shit just minutes after it released. Man, I should have went to sleep earlier. So get your pencils in your noses and your brain removers ready, since we're gonna dive in on Jeffy's 18th birthday and why it's a complete mess.
4 big guys, and they bust on my eyes, they eat my ass just like apple pie. If they keep fucking me like this, I might just die.
We start this piss take in a prison, where Logan deserves to be, and this cop guy gives the other cop guy a tour around this prison. And then, oh no, Jeffy's mom, who is a criminal, escapes prison. Who would have thought that would happen? And then we get introduced to this kidnapper clown who has a free candy man and... Wait. This is happening all too fucking fast. We are exactly 1 minute and 42 seconds into this fucking piss take, and 5 things already happened. The prison tour, this weird guy who wants to kiss him, the other prison tour, the escape, and the clown guy. And how did they record a free candy van in front of a fucking house without, you know, some people looking at it and questioning what the hell is happening? No, officer, we're just doing it for this very funny puppet video that kids really love watching. It might be handy later, but as of right now, we're doing nothing illegal! Anyway, coincidentally, Jeffy's mom and this clown team up, and then we go back to the police station where... wait a minute.
Don't worry, guy, I didn't forget today's your birthday!
Chief, you remembered my birthday!
Oh, great! This cop guy's birthday is also the same birthday as Jeffy's birthday. How am I gonna go without a sense and without a birthday? No, seriously, does this even make sense? So Mario... Marvin, okay. Okay, we're not gonna use characters, but we're actually gonna do it in other videos.
Okay, fuck you, Joel.
And wouldn't you know it, he's doing it for the money that Jeffy is getting for his birthday from his dead father. He wakes Jeffy up and says, "Hey twatbag, it's your birthday."
Yeah, Jeffy, you're 18 years old!
And look, he's being nice to him just so he could get money from him, but he doesn't know that he has to get money to him. Wow! Because he's stupid, you get it? And the next few minutes are literally just filler bad jokes and nothing really important happens here. But hey, this always happens in SML videos, so who am I to judge?
Oh, I've suddenly grown out of childish behavior.
Wait, really?
No.
And look at that! Jeffy's dad actually isn't dead! Who would have thought? Where was the foreshadowing in this? At all! And that leads to the very funny scene where Fuckface yells at his fuckface wife. Because he doesn't get to have the money Jeffy has. Oh wow. This scene goes on for way too long and just absolutely miserable to watch. It's not funny whatsoever. And after a wacky attempt to steal Jeffy, they accidentally steal Marvin. Oh no, watch out, old man. You really deserved it. And after 11 minutes of filler, yes, I counted it, they finally go and confront Jeffy's mom to take Marvin. But oh no, Jeffy's now kidnapped, what are they gonna do? Then they have a live action car chase scene and then, wait, aren't they risking their lives in this scene over here? Sure, they're not on the road, but goddammit, they're driving, what if they're just holding the camera and accidentally not looking on the road? And this then leads to the funniest scene in the whole video. Hey guys, look, Jeffy is dead. Apparently they actually destroyed the van just for this scene right here, and I think it's pretty much the most depressing thing ever. And look at that, Jeffy is actually not dead because he shot his mother in the face and jumped out the van just before the explosion happened. Marvin then apologizes for Jeffy for his mistake and learns to love him, yay. Didn't he already learn that in Jeffy's parents? And that's it. It was very absurd, but now that we went through the whole thing, let's start with the positives. The only positives I have for this piece of shit are there are two funny jokes and the explosion of the van is actually pretty cool. Yeah, now let's get to the bad stuff.
Pass the old El Crasso.
Just like I mentioned in the beginning of the video, I said that everything is just going out way too fast. Logan pretty much know about this and just had an idea to put filler, so much filler into this video. Secondly, all the characters are just unlikable. The villains are just very stereotypical and just, you know, not that interesting, and the good guys, as you would like to call them, can just go fuck off. They want to make my brains explode. Also, the message appreciating everyone you love, like, yeah, I like that message. It was been used in a lot of things, but like, here it just doesn't work. He goes, "I hate Jeffy. I want the money from him." He gets in danger. Actually, I like Jeffy. Fuck it. If Jeffy's dad actually is alive, then why don't they do something about this? I mean, only purpose he solves in this video is just, oh, he's alive! And that's pretty much it, he doesn't go see Jeffy, and yeah, you get the point. The places where the story takes place are just very empty, soulless, and, you know, just not fun to look at. Bowser Jr., Joseph, and Cody literally serve no purpose on it whatsoever. If you want to call it SML the movie, make it SML the movie, not Jeffy the movie, fuckface. A lot of the lines are very, very stupid and sometimes even questionable. Also, is it me or am I just tired of listening to the stupid SML SFX like all these sound effects and music just make me want to burst my ears open. I could go all day on and on and on how much I absolutely hate this video. It's just not fun, not entertaining, not cool, not anything. It just isn't anything good. Or is it? You see, in a twisting turn of events with no foreshadowing, I actually want to tell you why Jeffy's 18th birthday is secretly a masterpiece. You don't believe me? Just watch this part. You see, at my first viewing of this absolute masterpiece, I thought negatively on it. However, on deeper inspection, it is probably the best YouTube video to ever exist. The opening cinematic is truly lovely. This cop guy showing the other cop guy a tour around the prison. It is so lovely and iconic, yet people just don't see it as iconic for some reason. It is beautiful. The sets they put, the actor of the guy in the jail cell, the line delivery, it is beautiful. Don't even get me started to the part of Jeffy's mom leaving the prison. And suddenly, we get introduced to what is probably the best villain in all of media, the Clown Man, trying to steal kids with the free candy van. That is such an elaborate plan, such an evil, monstrous plan. His absolute great voice, and his goal of stealing kids is truly astonishing. Marvin just doing a whole birthday party so he could take money from Jeffy is truly also astonishing. He doesn't know his mistake, yet we as an audience know that it is a very big mistake of him. Jeffy is such an innocent kid, without him knowing that you'll get this tons of money. Imagine him being so happy getting it, without knowing he has to pay his adoptive father back. All the jokes that Jeffy makes are absolutely lovely. They're all so funny and had me laughing for hours and hours. All the lines he says are absolutely life-changing, and deserve to be in here. Without them, this movie just wouldn't be special. Every single character and scene in this absolute majesty of a movie deserves to be here. They all change the story in such small details, which even the best movies, even though they have all the non-filler characters, even some of those have and make to filler. The twist of Jeffy's father being actually alive just may be one of the best twists to ever exist. It is so unexpected and the viewers would never know that. The arguing scene of Marvin and his wife is really accurate to the arguments parents usually do in real life. It might just be better than arguing scenes in Breaking Bad or Count of the Monte Cristo. They're all just so great to watch. They're short, and they're important. While stealing Marvin was just an accident, it made the villains have lead of their objective. It is just a shocking scene with a mix of horror and, well, mystery. And the twist of Jeffy getting kidnapped was also another absolute gorgeous scene. The car chase that they have is absolutely realistic. And the explosion of the van? Yeah, that's the only bad thing I don't like about this. The scene of Jeffy's demise had me in tears. It gave me mental problems that I still have as of right now. I'm just not the same person after his absolute death. However, the twist of Jeffy actually being alive had me sad from happy. It was such a beautiful scene, it made my sad tears into happy tears. It's just a great scene and makes Marvin realize he has to appreciate his son for the mistake he did. I deeply apologize for me hating this, because Super Mario Logan, Jeffy's 18th birthday, could just be the best movie of all time.
Wait, Really?
Of course not. That would be stupid.
Yeah, no, this was always fucking trash. Fuck you, Logan. I'm glad I never another SML video from you. There you have it, ladies and gents. That was Super Mario Logan.